Get ready to match the stars from Soap, Robert Mandan, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Barnaby Jones, Lee Merriweather, from Carter Country, Richard Paul, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you all. Hello, Johnny. How are you? Hello, friends. Are you ready? I thank you for joining us. Are you quite ready to have a go at it?
You match the set.
Yes, I do.
Quite ready to have a go. Are you ready to have a go at it? Splendid.
Yes. Yes.
You do work cheap, don't you?
What the heck was
What's
that?
Comment?
I hope somebody blew their nose.
Someone. That's right. Let's say hello to Rich Garland and Carolyn Cohen. Okay, Rich Garland here, the current champ. He had a very big day at the races the last time we were together. He has a total of $10,600. Carolyn, is that our first round question? And matched every celebrity on the first rounder, a most unusual thing, because first round questions usually have two or three good answers, and she nailed them all with that one. And we'll see how you do. You'll have two shots at it to catch up with her. The best you can do is a tie. And you tune in 1 minute and 5 seconds and see how it turns out. Okay, little girl in the audience says, I hear you can gargle while you tap dance. So you're absolutely right. Are you ready? Here we go. One round, one question left for Rich Garland. And this is what it says. Dumb Dora is really dumb. To keep her hair in place, instead of using hairspray, she uses spray blank. That's how dumb she is. To keep her hair in place, instead of using hairspray, she uses spray blank. All right?
Hi, Elizabeth.
Here we go, Rich. Dumb Dora's really dumb, Rich. To keep her hair in place, instead of using hairspray, she uses spray blank.
Paint.
Spray paint. Spray paint is one possibility. Yes, sir?
And colors it as well.
Oh, there it is. 6-1. Brett?
Sometimes I'm better off on my own. Paint.
Wouldn't it be funny now if you didn't have it?
No, I mean on her own. How dark are those glasses?
Oh, Chuck. Okay, Leanne, instead of using hairspray, she uses spray paint.
Well, you see...
Yeah. This is called weaseling out for a rotten answer.
Well, it's not rotten in that you figure she wouldn't... I didn't think that she would want to color her hair with a horrible color. That she would just want it in place.
Yeah.
Really. So she'd use varnish.
Spray varnish. Which is really like a clear paint. Except it's a paint without any pigment in it.
Yeah.
All right?
No.
I'm trying for you, Rich.
Nothing, right?
But what the heck, you got 10,000 already.
So. Okay.
Now.
I don't see anything dumb about what Dora did. I painted mine brown this morning.
Oh, you did? Right. You missed a few places. That's right.
A couple of spots that
you missed, right. Okay, Miss Betty.
This is like Alan. He still calls himself a blonde.
Hey, listen, Rich, you got a shot at it here. The score is 6-5. Look at this. Now, since she's matched everyone, we'll just go by her and ask you to make a selection about A or B.
B.
B. Got one person to match. That's Leanne.
Oh.
Here it is. Bernie is the world's greatest salesman. He just sold Grizzly Adams a blank. Bernie is the world's greatest salesman. He just sold Grizzly Adams a blank. He just sold Grizzly Adams a...
razor.
A razor. He's a guy with a big, bushy beard. Grizzly Adams is a guy with a big, bushy beard. Yeah. You're in show business. You must know that, right?
Yes.
What do you say? He needs your match here in order to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Otherwise, you're going to send him away. Well, you're going to send him away, not me. I wouldn't do a thing like
that. It's all my fault. Yeah. No, but I figured he was the greatest salesman. He would sell him something he already has, which he has a big bear.
A big bear? So that means Carolyn Cohen wins the game. Congratulations. Get down a little blue spot. Get to you in a minute. Rich.
Hey, everybody.
You don't mind if I drink your...
No, go ahead.
Very good. Want to shake your hand?
Thank you.
Pleasure to have a hard-working, skillful carpenter here. Especially one who's won $10,600.
Bye-bye.
Rich Garland. Let's spin him off and spin a commercial. Ready? Here we are. With Carolyn Cohen, who's won her first game. She has $100, but now she could win a really big bundle here. Oh, she could win $10,000 or more. Let's find out how much she is going to win. Carolyn, we polled a studio audience, a very smart bunch like these. Not too long ago, we said, you write down your best answer to this. Blank jewels. If you do give us the answer that they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. Cash. Out of my pocket. If you match the answer they gave second most frequently, you get $250. And then for matching the third most popular answer, you get $100. Three of the six stars are going to give you a little help.
Betty?
Family.
Family jewels.
You should know.
All right.
Chuck. Does he mind what I call him?
No, he likes it when you call him Chuck. It makes him feel wonderful.
Don't help him, Betty. He doesn't deserve it.
What does that mean, dear?
Here.
Crown jewel.
Yeah. Is that your answer, crown jewel?
Well, I didn't say it was yet.
Well,
I'm
I heard your answer.
I'm contemplating it.
Yes.
Sweetheart. Hi. Crown jewels, I say.
And Brett.
Jesus.
I gave away!
Show some of your jewels.
Charles, she gave you an answer.
Right.
That's very vindictive of you, Charles.
The next time I save his blank, I hope that'll be the real jewels.
Real jewels, crown jewels,
dang.
And family jewels are the three they've given you. Now, you have the option here, Carolyn, of choosing one of those or giving us one of your own. What is your pleasure?
I like Betty's answer, family.
Family jewels. Everybody likes Betty's answer. Everybody likes Betty's. All right. We want family jewels. Let's see if we got family jewels here anywhere. May we see the $100 response?
Precious.
Precious jewels. All right. Let's see if we get family jewels out of the $250 number. Yes, we do. Congratulations, Carol. You got $250 more. Making a total of $350. What do you think's under the big one? Crown, they say. Crown jewels. Crown jewels. You want to make a
artwork is about a foot higher.
Yes. Yeah. You want to make a little side bet?
You know something I don't?
What? No, I don't know.
Hey, let's go. Gee, it's nice here. All right, go ahead. It's warmer. It's much warmer.
Yes, it is. Very
rug
hot.
Is better.
Right, that's why.
All right, go ahead. Slide it. Oh.
Thank you very much. He left his calling card. Slide it, Bob. That's Ori back there. Yeah. Ori, are you back there? Knock twice if for yes. Yes, that's Ori. Oh, yeah. No, that's not Ori the horse. That's... Okay, now, you've won $250. That means the least you can be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $2,500. However, if you have a good lucky spin of the star wheel here, you could double that and be playing for $5,000. You know how it goes. We'll determine which star you'll be playing with and for how much. Give it a good spin. It must make one revolution. Go. All right. It's all automatic. If the light comes on, that means you're going to be playing for a double. Robert, it's you again. Robert.
No, it isn't.
It's Robert.
Yes, it is.
Yes.
Oh, I thought it was Lee.
No, it's Robert.
Oh, I'm so
it's
isn't that sad? The arrow is a foot long.
She can't.
Isn't it sad?
No, she's not going downhill that day.
His hat falls off.
Robert did so well yesterday. I don't know. The wheel just likes him, I guess.
I guess.
Are you ready?
I kind of like
Here
the
wheel. Here we go. Blank Usher. Blank Usher. Or Blank Usher. It's kind of a hard one. Are you thinking about it? Okay, Carolyn. Right. You got to put it in the slot there. Okay. Now he's finished. Give us the answer that matches his, and we give you $2,500. There it is. Blank Usher.
I have two possibilities, but I'll go with movie.
Movie Usher. Okay. Movie Usher. Now here in the big money, it must be an exact match. So, Robert, may we see your card, please?
Well, it's close, but it's not exact. You
probably theater. Usher is not.
Sorry.
I mean, they both had the identical idea, but the rule says here, when you're going for the big money, it must be
exact.
An exact match.
Darn.
All right, House of Usher would have been another possibility. All right,
Head
what's
Usher.
That?
CBS Usher.
CBS Usher. Yes,
NBC
they're all over the place
Usher.
Here. Now, Carolyn, you ready to meet another player?
Right.
All right, let's all welcome Rosie Mitchell. Hello, Rosie. What do you say, Rosie?
All right.
Put that right up there as soon as it stops. Let's welcome Rosie Mitchell and find out where she's from and what she does and if she's married or anything she wants to contribute.
Well, Jane, I am from Toledo, Ohio. I am Rosie Mitchell, you know.
You are the Rosie Mitchell.
Yes, and I'm from Toledo, Ohio. I'm married.
Now, wait a minute. You're not an imposter. You are Rosie Mitchell.
I am Rosie Mitchell.
Okay, I just want to make sure you're Rosie Mitchell. That's
all. That's who I am.
Okay.
And I have six children,
yeah?
16 grands.
Really?
And, well, I work every day, and... I have been wanting to get on Magic Game for 5 years.
And here you are.
And here I am.
Well, we welcome you and wish you the best of luck, Rosie.
Thank you.
All right. Rosie from Toledo will have a choice of A or B.
I'll take B.
B, says Rosie. Here it is. Say, did you hear the results of the public opinion survey?
Uh-uh.
No,
well,
I didn't hear that.
Here it is. They told Blank she had been named Couple of the Year.
What?
Public opinion survey. They told Blank she had been named Couple of the Year.
I don't understand that.
Oh, it's so
obvious. Oh, it's so easy.
You don't understand it. I am amazed at a woman of your intelligence, a famous author, playwright.
Oh, pardon me. I'm sorry. It just took a minute.
Yes.
Feel free. He didn't have any changes. He's new.
They told Blank she had been named Couple of the Year.
The Honeymooners of the Year? Oh, boy.
I guess you really didn't understand the question, but we have to accept that as your answer because that's the way the rules are. What did you say?
Can you read it?
Christine Jorgensen. All right.
Well, wasn't that the answer?
Well, that's one possibility, yes.
Well, you were so mean to me that I said Christine Jorgensen, and you scared me into it.
Really?
That wasn't really what I wanted to say, but she...
Yeah. Well, there's another one that's quite good. There are two others that are quite good. What do you say?
Rosie, you should have waited another year for a good question. Raquel Welch.
Raquel Welch is a good answer. Raquel Welch had been named Couple of the Year.
I don't get that kind of smut.
All right.
There's a good reason why you don't get it, Brett.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, if you got them, flaunt them, right? What do you say?
Well,
you didn't understand it either. Nobody
no,
understands
I didn't.
These questions.
There was, well, there was
I understood
just
it.
I had to. Well, the fat lady. Now, there was so much
they,
of her
they
that
told
they
told a fat
two
lady
of them.
Should be named two Couple of the Year.
Two
okay.
I don't.
All right.
Well,
yes.
I don't
know. I don't. All right,
From
Richard Paul.
From the mountains to the prairies.
Kate Smith. Couple of the Year. Another possibility. Yes.
I think of Christine Jorgensen as two possibilities.
Yes. Yeah. But the one that no one really thought of, and which would be a popular response in this day and age because of her popularity, is Dolly Parton. Could you think that she'd be named?
They're nice.
He
wanted yeah. to do the tennis player, but he couldn't remember her name.
Yeah, so I cheated.
So, Rosie, you had a tough one. But we got a tough one for her, too. But right now, we've got this for America. Thank you, Johnny O. Let's carry on here. The other round one test question for Carolyn Cohen. Benny the cab driver said, driving in New York City is getting so dangerous. Yesterday, I had to trade my cab for a blank. That's how dangerous driving in New York City is getting. Yesterday, I had to trade my cab for a blank.
So dangerous.
Dangerous. Driving in New York City. Yesterday, I traded my cab for a blank.
Don't peek.
Wonderful.
No, I'm talking to Gene. He's peeking at him.
Don't let him peek.
It's my show. I can peek if I want to. I mean, you peek on your show, don't you?
What's it to you?
All right, Carolyn. Benny the cab driver said, driving New York City is getting so dangerous. Yesterday, I had to trade my cab for a blank.
Tank.
Tank is a good answer, I think. Tank would be good. Tank would be a good answer.
They're so aggressive.
That's another good one there.
Thought, yeah.
Tank and ambulance, is another good possibility there. Yes.
I like tank. I wish I'd thought of tank. That's a terrific answer. And it's true, too. I said ambulance, too.
Ambulance is also excellent, yes.
I said like a combination of both, armored car.
Armored car. Another good one. Yeah, the round one questions usually have more than one good response, and this is a perfect example of it. Lee?
Mm-hmm. The same as Charles.
Another armored car.
Boy, you driven in New York lately?
Yeah.
You don't have a tank. You're really in trouble.
Uh-huh. Carolyn Cohen picks up one there.
But there are those New York cab drivers who don't say tanks. That I said armored car.
Armored car. Yeah, many of them don't say tanks, no matter how big the tip is there. No, they're a good bunch, those New York cab drivers. Here we go to round two. Rosie, again, you got a choice of A or B.
Gene, I'll take A.
You'll take A. You had B last time, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
Didn't do too well with it, did you?
No, I didn't.
Here it is. You know who Howard Cosell is?
Yes.
You do. All right, here it is. Last night, Howard Cosell talked so much, he hurt himself.
Oh.
Now he has to wear a blank on his tongue. Last night, Howard Cosell talked so much he hurt himself. Now he has to wear a blank on his tongue.
Who is Howard Cosell?
Howard Cosell.
Who is that?
It is absolutely incredible to me that in this day and age, someone of higher than average intelligence would not be cognizant of the presence of Howard Cosell.
Oh, cognizance. Yes, now I know who. Yes. Thank you, Gene.
You ready, Rosie? Last night, Howard Cosell talked so much, he hurt himself. Now he has to wear a blank on his tongue.
His toupee. Oh, no. One
has to wear his toupee on his tongue?
Soften it up.
No. To stop the flow of blood. That would make a very hairy tongue there, wouldn't it?
I just thought of that. I wish I hadn't.
Yes.
Well, I figured he would probably need some kind of support on his tongue, so I said a truss.
A truss. A truss to hold his tongue in place there. What?
Well, I didn't think of toupee, but I thought you probably have to put a little cast on it.
Oh, wouldn't that be good? Then he couldn't talk there.
I have friends out there.
A cast.
Two casts and one truss so far. Rosie?
Yes.
Howard Cosell hurt himself. Now he has to wear a blank on his tongue.
It's just a picture of this that kills me. Band-aid.
A band-aid? A band-aid, Rosie.
Sorry, Rosie.
I know.
Anything but a toupee would help there, wouldn't it?
Maybe it could. Last time I saw him, he was going like this.
Yeah. Oh, that to get the hair.
It was a truss.
It was a truss.
Sorry.
Now you must match Betty to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Here we go.
I think a toupee is a funnier picture than a band-aid, but I said a splint.
A splint would be good. That means Carolyn Cohen wins the game. All right. You know where to go. You've been there before. We'll say goodbye to Rosie Mitchell.
No,
Rosie,
quite.
We're going to send some gifts. Remember Johnny talking about all those gifts? Well, some of those gifts will be coming your way in Toledo, Ohio. When are you going back?
On Wednesday.
You're going back on Wednesday.
Uh-huh.
Well, I hope you have a good, safe trip back, and thank you for coming here. I'm sorry you didn't win more money, but wait a minute.
Thank you.
I wasn't finished talking to Rosie. Rosie, you mustn't leave until the king says dismissed. Now, Rosie.
Oh, where are you?
I'm right here now, Rosie. Now, how are you going back?
I'm going back the way I came.
How's that?
On the plane.
You're going back on the plane? Yeah. What? I'm just talking to Rosie there. We don't want to talk to you. Well, I hope you have a safe trip. We're going to send you some nylons and, oh, we got all kinds of wonderful things. Z-brick, you can build a new house. There's Jack built. You can fade anytime you want. I'll just sit here and chat. Now, do a slow fade. Go to black.
Thank you.
No time. Oh, there's no time. But I want to say goodbye anyway. You were wonderful. Join us next time on Game 7018. Raven, goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Chapman production. This program was edited for broadcast.